Welcome back to Monmouth in Focus. I'm Cynthia Scott. We're joined by Freeholder Deputy Director Serena DiMaso, liaison to the county's Division of Workforce Development. Thanks so much for joining us.
Always my pleasure.
So let's talk a little bit about what the Workforce Development Division does.
Well, it actually directs the delivery of education and employment and training, not only to residents, but to businesses in our county. It maximizes resources between the Board of Chosen Freeholders and the competitive workforce and businesses, and just puts them all together so that we can employ as many people as we can.
And specifically, what types of services do they offer?
There are two one-stop career centers. There's one in Eatontown and one in Neptune, and they help you with things like writing your resume or even job interviews, help you do a job interview. We have businesses come in and actually do interviews on our premises. Mm. They also have a program called the Learning Link, where we teach people how to use computers and we let them have access to finding jobs. And we also help people get their GEDs so that they can in fact go on and get a good job.
Yeah, because if they're not in the workforce for a while, they need to that jump start, and that's what this sounds like it does.
We have a lot of people who maybe lost their career, lost their job, and are changing careers, and so they come in and it's really a one-stop shop for anybody who's looking for any kind of employment. Mm-hmm. It's a great service.
And a few new businesses have opened up in Monmouth County. How does that help the employment?
A lot of them come to our development offices and ask for help in interviewing people. As a matter of fact, just recently Whole Foods opened in Wall, and they had over 800 applications, and they used our offices to do their interviews. So they had 800 applications. From that, they had 400 group interviews. From that, they narrowed it down to 300 personal interviews, and then they hired 150 of those people, Monmouth County residents, for employment in their store. So it's really a win-win for everybody.
So they do a great job, it sounds like, of connecting the new businesses with those seeking employment.
Right. Another new business is the Asbury Hotel in Asbury Park.
Yeah.
Over 200 construction workers were put to work so that we can build that through our department. And it's a $30 million project. Which is great for the economic development of the county. And now there's 128 full-time people employed there at the hotel.
Hotel, that's fantastic. And you hear so many people saying, oh, I applied for this job online, never heard back, I applied for this. I don't want to say circumvents, but this is another way for assistance, and it's person to person. You're not on a computer just applying for something and never hearing back.
Right, and the other thing we do is we have job fairs. So in order to be a participant in the job fair, you have to have a job available. So again, you have that one-on-one contact.
Right.
So the businesses come, and we usually host them at Brookdale Community College. And the businesses come, they set up a table, and you bring your resume, and you're actually meeting the recruiter for that business. And people are placed in jobs every day because of that particular workforce development program. And it's a great opportunity for the freeholders, workforce development, and the board, which is made up of some county employees, some government employees, and businesses around the community.
To
make sure that our residents are employed.
Yeah. And it's good to know that there's an array of opportunity out there as well. Thanks so much for joining us, Freeholder, on a real important topic.
Yes.
Appreciate you being here. And of course, you can go to www.visitmonmouth.com for more information. I'm Cynthia Scott.